I'll just continue with the story then, in that case. So there he is. There's the boy. Just sort of rolled it up there. And the mole there. I don't know if I better do it to both there. So you did well. One of our greatest freedoms, said the mole, is how we react to things. And we're just like a little bit of artwork there. I'm going to start sharing the artwork things. It's quite nice as well. Oh, look. Lovely morning, said the mole. Shall we get going? So going to just out, just walk in. And I'm going to do as usual. I am going to actually pause when I think there's the life lesson. You can tell me to pause as well. Whoops, you're rolling, cried the boy. You look like a snowball. No, a mobile. No, a mole ball. A snow mole. Stop rolling. Goodness me, said the mole. And just having a bit of fun rolling down the hill. Oh, gosh, no, the river. Look out. So just going down, rolling towards the river. Tension. Need tense music there. And the mole goes into the water. I'm getting better at this, actually. The mole goes into the water. Take my hand, boy says. And then, oh, no, the fox. And the fox starts to come by the river. So we'll see what happens. And the fox is going by the river. Can see the fox there. Can see that. Okay, guys on TikTok, there we go. Just going by the river. And there you go. The fox saves the mole. So thank you, said the mole. Thank you, said the boy. So they're just congratulating the fox and give him a bit of a cuddle. Oh, the fox is back. And they're walking together down, sort of like together now, so almost. Oh, the fox is back. Do you think he's coming with us? Asked the boy. Oh, I do hope so. Maybe he's lost too. Well, I think everyone feels a bit lost sometimes, said the mole. I know I do. So I'm going to stop there. So, about being lost. Have you guys ever sort of experienced anything like that or anything in your world around being lost at all? Like in metaphorically?
I was going to say metaphorically or literally, because the answer is yes to both of them.
Yeah, same.
You're same here, actually. Do you want to give any examples of what that might be or anything like that?
So once, I can't remember what it was, it was a college, and we were out doing paintballing and we were playing capture the flag. And I decided to make a break for the flag. I ran out into the middle of the forest, grabbed the flag, suddenly had no idea that what direction I should be going in, heard everyone shouting that way, couldn't see a person. I was completely lost and disorientated.
Okay.
Oh, you wanted the metaphorical one, not the literal one.
Oh, I love that. Well, it doesn't matter. Any you do.
I think it's just sometimes when you, for me, it's about direction. So when you've got really big, potentially insurmountable feeling experiences ahead of you, it's just that feeling of not knowing where to start or where to go or how, you know, not even being able to visualize the end result, but knowing that you've got this kind of mountain to climb. And I think that happens less the older you get, because your experience starts to help fill that in. You know, things do get overcome, and you know, something that might take 2 years feels like an eternity. But again, that's, you know, 2 years now to me feels like nothing. Sure, it feels like even less than nothing to you, Joe, at your grand old age. But I've definitely had those moments where you just, yeah, you don't know where you're going, or you know where you want to go, but it just seems like it's an impossible journey.
Moving towards those goals that you may not think you'll ever accomplish them. Maybe they're too large, yes. Or you think they're too large. It's just massive. And yeah, I mean,
or it's just, you know, it's out of your reach. It's something you'd yeah. never be able to attain, even though it's where you want to go.
Ryan, what about you? Anything?
I think if you look at the story in particular, like the mole was just saved. I don't want to get too literal in the story, but if you envisage that, you know, you've gone down the wrong path, or you've had a change, or you've had an issue that you've either saved yourself from or somebody saved you from, it's very easy to not know where to go next. It's very easy to kind of get confused with what the right decision is, because you've been burnt. You know, you've perhaps taken the wrong path, or you made the wrong decision. You've been burnt by the flame of wrongdoing or whatever. And, you know, sometimes you really are unsure of the right way to go. And I think I've definitely had that. And I imagine the pair of you are somewhat similar as well.
Yeah, definitely. And thanks, Ryan, for actually sort of bringing the story in and saying, obviously, the fox was, you know, the mole was saved in the end. And obviously that deed was that he released the fox from the snare. And that happened. It's almost like you don't know what you do is going to have an impact later on down the line. I think there's a lot of in that story. So thanks for that. And the mine, I was lost. And, you know, sort of building on what you guys have said, is for me, what was my mental health was like my depression. I told this before, where when I was in my mental, you know, when I had anxiety and depression, I just felt I was doing a rinse and repeat. I think I've said this before on the podcast, where I was just coming to work, getting up, going to work, coming home, going to sleep, and doing a cycle of rinse and repeat. And I felt lost. I felt, you know, my lost, my version of lost, like this mole was saying, that, you know, the mole was saying, and, you know, was saying for me, it's like, why am I here? What's the purpose? And I felt lost. I felt like, you know, what's the point of me being here? You know, is this it? Is this the whole point of it? So, you know, that's where I think for me, is what it speaks to me, is that, you know, we all sometimes feel lost. And I felt very lost at that point, and I needed to sort of find what my purpose was about. And that's why, you know, we're doing this together. You know, I'm glad we're so together doing this sort of thing, because for me, this drives my purpose, and I no longer feel lost. I feel like, oh, I now know, for me, it's about trying to help others and helping, you know, helping myself as well, firstly, and trying to get better and be better, and, you know, and pass on anything that I learn, you know, through coaching and things like that. And this podcast, you know, sharing mental health, and that everybody goes through it. And, you know, sometimes you're going to feel lost. Sometimes you're not going to know where your particular direction is. You've got a general direction, but you're heading in that way. But you don't necessarily, I think Lee's talked about before, you don't necessarily know the exact steps or the exact detail. And in fact, you don't need to know the detail. Just as long as you're heading in the sort of right direction, you will find a way. And those are things I really struggle with, because I want a specific outcome. So that was my lost part. And that was a really big moment in life that, you know, I might not have been here, but I did. I got help, and you know, the rest, as you say, is history. And looking backwards now, you know, I had to go through that to get to this point, which is painful. I wouldn't wish it on anyone, but I wouldn't change it, because I wouldn't be here I wouldn't be here with you guys. So yeah, that was my lost moment. And that's a really big lost moment in my life, in terms of my own personal mental health. And of course, I've lost my mum. And again, there's a certain, you know, you have a guiding person and they're not there anymore. But I'm imagining now, you know, coming, you know, soon going to be the anniversary for my mum passing, that I'm trying to think of, you know, my mum's still inside me here, and I know she would sort of want me to continue the things that I'm doing.